Hello everybody and welcome to our 30k subscriber video! Dude, what the heck? Dudes and dudettes and all other people who have subscribed, what the heck? Why? Seriously. But no, I did not ever think we would freaking get to 30k. That's crazy, but yeah. It's friggin' awesome. It's great that we can, it's super cool that we can make these goofy videos. And
okay, well look, we've got a lot of subscribers, but when I go to the analytics, I see that most people watching are not subscribed.
No way, what? If you're not subscribed, hit the subscribe button so that we can get up to, what are we aiming for, 100% subscribed?
I mean, ideally, yeah.
Yeah, there you go. Help support the cause. I know it's like been a month since we're at like 30, almost 32k now. Yeah. Look, it's we put out a video every day. We've got a lot of other stuff, but I have been working on it, and so here it is, okay? And I hope you like it. It's just some random garbage is usual with these videos, but I hope you like it. But yeah, so we wanted to have a Q&A segment. There's some good questions here, so let's go through them. Question from Yin Yang YT, congrats to both of you. Question: when did you two hear about WG Comics? Well, I remember I started reading, I found out about No Lunch Break in, oh, when was that? That would mean like before it was 100 pages,
maybe late 2017, something like
yeah,
that.
Yeah, yeah, or even, because when did we start our channel?
I mean, May, so maybe it
May
was
2017.
May 2018. So it must, maybe it was
I
early
think it may have been early 2018 then, that I heard about No Lunch Break and it was, you know, downhill from there. I mean, I probably knew about some comics before that, but like, you know, that's when I found out about No Lunch Break, and then I think, I mean,
yeah, I heard about it when we started the channel, so I guess yeah, that was only a few months later.
Mm. There's a game all about fatties called Tribal Hunter. Yes, there is. It's actually really good. I have played it, and I haven't finished it, because the final boss is freaking hard, but it's so, I mean, I love, like Metroidvania games. Like, I really like Shantae and stuff, and so if you like games like that, like Shantae or Hollow Knight,
I mean,
or whatever,
it's a bit like Kirby, isn't it?
Oh, it is like Kirby. You're right, it is like Kirby, Kirby, but with like fat dragons. It's real. Like, seriously, it's a really fun game. Like, definitely check it out. Another Skullgirls gameplay vid. When? Yeah, that was a series we just kind of.
I mean, it wasn't. It was a reasonably entertaining video to make. I'm not sure if it's the best, like, would be the best review-wise, but, you know.
Some people did seem to really enjoy it, but it wasn't like a, it's not some, like, one of our core things, like, I guess. It did have fat art in it, but, like, yeah. It wasn't something that drew a whole lot of people, but it'd be a fun, interesting series to continue. Maybe Villain the Snoods or our alt channel or something, oh, yeah. Maybe at some point, I don't know. How do both started with this interest? I don't know, man. Matthias Gabriel. I don't know, individual person. I think I've just been an appreciator of the thick all my life. It just kind of, you know, made sense, you know.
I mean, I guess I just started reading the comics for the channel. That's pretty much it.
Yeah, that's basically it. Yeah, and he's kind of roped in with this. So yeah. I don't know. I've just always thought that thick individuals are pretty based. Because I'm, you know, a bit of a Sigma male. Oh, and this is another one. Why did you start doing dubs on fat comics?
I guess you just said it would be a cool idea and we did it. That's pretty
much
it.
Yeah, yeah. We were starting a YouTube channel, but we had no idea what content we wanted to make. So we were like, well, let's throw some things at a wall. Let's do some Fortnite gameplay. And then I was like, hey, well, there's these, like, comics about fat people on DeviantArt. that would be a funny, funny haha video to make. Yeah. And I mean, it is funny haha, that is our whole brand. But that would be a funny video to make. I don't know if anyone would watch it. But people did watch it, and so we were like, well, people liked seeing the fat, the no lunch break, and the fat people. I guess we'll make more videos like this, and people watch those, and so yeah, it's mostly because of you people watching these videos that we keep, that this is the content. Otherwise, I don't know, we'd do like political commentary, or we'd Fortnite video gameplay with like obnoxious loud intro yeah. music, or like calling our mother at 3 a.m. or something. I don't know. So thanks for letting us do this. It's certainly better than some alternatives. Here's a version of my favorite song, Sir Mix-a-Lot. It's called I Like Fat Girls Guts. I like fat girls' guts, and I can't deny, tell another that I can't lie, when wiggle and jiggles in my face, I get sprung, baby got fat. Nice. Very nice. Very nice, Chris. Thank you. Favorite fat-related comic? This is the real question.
I mean, we've read a lot of really good ones. I mean, I probably biased towards some of the recent ones you're reading, because we're currently into...
Yeah, yeah, that is true.
One choice.
I mean, to be fair, like, I think Fat Note is a pretty neat comic. It's probably not my favorite, but like Fat Note is pretty epic. What would the other ones be? No Lunch Break is obviously a standout. Yeah. Like, we're kind of like the No Lunch Break voice people. It's kind of like, it's very, 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 it was very impactful for us. So honestly, one serving choice. I am really in love with this comic. It's so good. But what other ones would
I mean, there's Losing Control, that's a great one.
Yeah, Losing Control is really good. I think it's just, it's too depressing. It's not my favorite, because it Losing Control is a good comic. I just no, seriously. There's so many comics we have read. Is there a really good Lord Storm? I mean, there's some really good Lord Stormcooler ones.
Yeah. Sweet Dream Coffee as well.
Oh, my gosh, I do like Sweet Dream Coffee's comics. The friggin' Way to Experience is pretty friggin' good. I mean, even like the. I'm now remembering like Pound for Pound Cake's one about the friggin' demon cult in an alternate universe America. That one was wild. So I know that doesn't really answer the question, but basically there's a lot of comics we have read, and I like a lot of them. But I'll go No Lunch Break, because it's just such an iconic comic for us. The questions are for both of you. What was your first exposure to weight gain art, comics, animation, etc. online? I don't know, man. Probably just reading weird fan fictions on the line, probably.
And I guess I've already answered it.
Yeah, Snide just got drawn into it with this channel. I remember saw Metal Forever a long, long time ago. Kurokaze, maybe? Yeah, I don't know. It's in the misty past. I can't really... Sorry that's such a bad answer, but I know I've known about like Metal Forever for a long, long time. That's one of the artists I remember. And Snow-chan DA, I remember seeing years and years and years ago. Out of all the comics you've dubbed on your channel, do you have a favorite? Oh no, someone else is asking the thing.
Okay, well,
do you have a favorite?
Like, we've already answered favorite comic. So if it's like favorite one to dub, I would say the Domino Effect's probably up there with...
My gosh, that blanked from my mind. Oh my goodness. Domino Effect is so... I love doing the Domino Effect dub. It's so good. Oh man, that might... if I'm gonna be... I don't like to be like, oh, this person's comic is better, but like, the Domino Effect is amazing. It's seriously just like... so much like plot for a fat comic, but also all about, for, like, I don't know, it's pretty wild. Crazy. It's also got Elijah, which I'm biased towards as well, because he's, you know, I really resonate with him, because I also am a Sigma male. But anyway, what would you say to someone that feels embarrassed for being interested in this type of material? Good question. I'm not good at giving life advice. I don't know. I guess I'd just say, on the one hand, thick appreciation, I feel, has come a long way. Like, sure, not everyone's gonna be, you know, like, oh yeah, down with, like, the lady that's the size of a house, but, you know, we've come a long way where people are, like, appreciating the thickness. And I mean, I don't know, you know, you got a sickness for the thickness, and it's pretty... There are a lot of weird stuff out there, and liking having a sickness for the thickness is a pretty like normal kind of thing compared to so many other weird stuff. That's not very good advice, I know. I don't know. Snide, you what advice would you have for someone who was embarrassed about about watching our videos?
I have no idea.
Yeah, we got nothing. I'm sorry. You're going to have to go to someone else who's actually has good life advice. I'm sorry. Revenge.
Yeah, there'll probably be
this is such a good question.
Probably be a new revenge recently soon.
I think so, yeah. I just know there's a lot of revenge that recently that, like, revenge is getting very spicy, which means that Susan Wojcicki, who's probably will, you know, have an allergic reaction to the kind of revenge stuff that's going on. So, but hopefully sometime more, because I know people who are very, very into revenge. But yeah, those were some very, very roundabout answers, long-winded answers to some very basic questions. Well, thanks again for 30k subscriber guys. You are awesome guys, gals, pals, etc. And yeah, I hope you enjoy the rest of this video. It's just some random stuff we came up with.
Hi everybody, I'm Boss Rob, and in today's Happy Little Accident, I'm going to be hosting the segment of this 10,000 subscriber special. So usually Snide Sniffer got me painting something, but I wanted something a little different for you guys. So today I'll be reviewing a handful of depictions of apes and monkeys in medias. And before you all forget, you're apes as well. You're not special. Anyways, let's start. And first off, we have King Kong. Oh, the big boy. Oh, I cry every time I see these movies. He's just wants to chill on his island, and they take him off to New York City, and look, if I went to New York City, first of all, I'd want to see the top of the New York Empire State Building, too. And also, I'd be fucking pissed, too, if I was taken off my island and taken to some weird city. Don't know why I had to kidnap that one woman. I don't think I'd do that. I'd say 8 out of 10 for our big king boy here. Rest in peace, man. Still makes me. Still makes me choke up. Anyways, moving on. Next up, we got Caesar from the Planet of the Apes. A remake, reboot, prequels. A chimpanzee with a shotgun. I mean, like, what's not to love? Yes, very, very badass. I like seeing some badass apes here. So this is definitely this. I approve of this. I give this at least an 8 out of 10. Gorilla Grodd. Now, he's a very smart gorilla. I like that. Well, I don't know much about him because he hasn't been any like main line cinematic DC movies. I do know in the Batman Ninja anime movie, he's voiced by the same voice actor as Dio from JoJo. So. That's very epic. That's a happy little accident right there. I'll happily give him a 7 out of 10. Now this fella here, he's Monkey D. Luffy, and I don't know why he's on this list. He doesn't look much like a monkey to me, so that's a 1 out of 10. I don't understand. Am I like being pulled a bit here? I don't know. Oh my boy Winston. You know I'm in Winston and Overwatch. I mean, I don't play Overwatch because I'm Boss Rob, but he's a scientist. He's such a chill guy. He eats peanut butter. I would wish I could give Winston a 10 out of 10, but I have to settle for an 8 out of 10 because of Blizzard. Anyways, yeah, 8 out of 10 for Winston. Very cool guy. Love the glasses. I want some of those myself. Ah, yes, Wukong from the Lego Monkey Kid. I am so happy to see Lego respecting the monkeys and making such a cool monkey, very cool anime monkey. Now, Monkey D. Luffy, this is what I was expecting when you said there was a monkey in an anime. Like, this is what I wanted, not that. Not whatever that guy was. Anyways, 9 out of 10, very cool. No, 10 out of 10, very epic. Now this one here, this is the true Lego monkey. When I say I want Lego monkey, this is what I'm talking about. Now that, oh, that's so beautiful. I should try painting this monkey. Oh, it's so fantastic. Phenomenal. I love it. I own like about like 99 of these little fellas. I just can't get enough of the classic Lego monkey. 11 out of 10. So, yeah, that was a random segment, but I hope you all enjoyed it, and I hope you enjoy the rest of this 30k subscriber special. I wanna give a very applause to Snide and Sniff. They, well done, guys, well done. I don't know why 30,000 people want to subscribe to Snide and Sniff, and no one wants to see my painting streams on Twitch. Please, guys, I know I made a couple of happy little accidents, but if I, why won't you come to my streams? Anyways, guys, that's all for me. Thanks for your time, and I hope you enjoy painting something, I guess. Bye.
Da 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 da.
Hello, everyone, and welcome to Gaming in the Biden Years. My name is the Miffed Penguin Gamer, and today we're going to be going over some of the fantastic and not so fantastic games released in the era of Biden.
GTA Definitive Edition is definitively worse than the original games. Why remaster a game if you can't even make it better than the original? That's like taking a car to the mechanic to fix a blown tire, and they give it back to you with the brakes not working. Speaking of, this very thing happened to me recently, which is why I'm currently running an Indiegogo campaign to afford a new car. On a side note, CJ from Grove Street was my role model growing up. I tried to be just like him by pulling people out of cars. I quickly found out that Grand Theft Auto didn't lead to fame and fortune, it led to juvenile detention. Ah well, another childhood dream crushed. Resident Evil 8 is the latest installment in the Resident Evil series, a game series known equally for its frightening zombie enemies and smoking hot babes. The latter is definitely present this time in the form of Lady Dimitrescu, a 9-foot-tall vampire mommy. The marketing made it seem like she would be the main villain, but she is only present for a small part of the actual game, making this entry ultimately not worth your time. Fun fact, the game is called Biohazard in Japan. This sounds more like we're getting up close and personal with fecal matter than zombies, so this was an excellent change.
Damn, they sure don't make these for my little penguin hands.
Scott Cawthon has really outdone himself with this new entry into the scariest game series of all time. The graphics in this new game are truly incredible, and if you don't agree, you're off your rocker, old man. It is great that we're finally able to move around in a FNAF game, even more so as you'll want to be running straight into the arms of the moody goth wolf Roxy. The game adds even more terrors who will occasionally teleport you out of the map, to out-of-bounds locations from where you will never escape. I don't know how this phenomenon fits into the lore, but I'm sure Matt Pat will figure it out. if you have friends, this is an excellent game to play. However, we all know that gamers don't have friends. They're too busy grinding for waifus and Genshin Impact to form real connections with their fellow humans, making this game's premise a terrible idea. That would be like making a game about being socially acceptable and marketing it to English sports fans. Compounding all this, I'm still not over my divorce with Karen. She took the kids, and I'm not about to forgive her. This game just brings back painful memories. But if you have friends and no emotional baggage, you might find this game fun. Diablo 2 Resurrected is a lot like the original Diablo 2, so if you enjoyed that game, you will probably enjoy this one. If only this game resurrected my relationship with my wife Karen, I'd probably say this was game of the year, if not the decade. The graphics are far better than the original. However, the Amazon now looks like Willem Dafoe, and I don't know how I feel about that. The Barbarian, on the other hand, looks like Drax from Guardians of the Galaxy. Clearly Blizzard is looking to grab the Marvel audience, which is a smart move considering the popularity of the movies. I wish they could have gotten Dave Bautista on to voice him. I would have loved to hear Drax's voice as I slaughter my way through the legions of hell.
That's all from me for the day, everyone. Now I'm gonna go and play some League of Legends to forget about my messy divorce. Video games really can be an escape from the harsh realities of life.
Okay guys, I am hyped. We are doing a new Kip Waifu Tier List! And Husbando, we got a couple of them. But yeah, it's been... When did we do the last one even? It was
3+ years ago or something like that.
Holy moly, we hadn't even like finished no lunch break or anything, or even like dinner with sister. So let me like suffice to say, there's a lot of like updates we got. We got a lot of dudes and ladies down here. We've got everyone who's important here, including Sean, because I can't leave out my epic boy. So anyways, I guess we should start with Sydney here, like Sydney, our main girl. And she's kind of the most iconic Kip character.
Yeah.
I would say Sydney has to be pretty high.
Yes, they're a very cool character, but the only real issues are, like, they have some character flaws, I guess.
They do have some character flaws, but it's what makes them relatable. Like Sydney is a degenerate just like us. She has a lot of... She is flawed, but that just makes her more relatable. Like, she's such a friggin'... She's such a disaster of a person. Sydney is, like, just a disaster of a person. What would we say? A for Sydney. Yes, she is flawed, but it's kind of relatable. But maybe not quite, yes, because, yes, she's a little bit of a walking disaster. This is an obvious one. We have Fina. Goodness, I always call her Sara. Fina, which is an obvious S tier. I think we agreed on this last time.
Any sequences or anything that where they're the main character. You don't really see them do much, you know.
Yeah, I mean, yeah, they're more of a minor character, but they're like, they're a gamer girl, okay? Yeah. They're a gamer girl. They're the one straight character in the game. They are they're depressed, relatable. They have a very, very relatable living situation where they have bags of Doritos lying around their room. I think they still have to go S. I guess we'll continue on the trend of like Sydney's friends group. We've got Sarah.
Yeah, they're a bit of a person who, you know, tries to get other people to follow up, you know, their lifestyle, I guess.
They're
they're better than the other people because they're thin.
They lose weight and they're a bit boring and they're just like the...
They're just sensible, that's basically it, isn't it?
Not very relatable. Too high achieving. They have their life together too much. They do have their life together, which I guess is kind of good.
And they're not even hugely fat at the end of it.
Yeah, it's like a C for Sara. Like, I don't think we'd go lower because, you know... You know, she does have a life together. She's got cute glasses. But, yeah, it'd have to be a C. Okay, and then lastly, we've got Tina. Now, obviously, Tina's hella gay, but we're ignoring that for these purposes, okay? You know, I mean, like, you know, if we were in the Kipverse, we would probably also be lesbians, because that's just how it works, okay? I don't make the rules.
Tina's, like, there's some other nice characters, but, like, they don't really do anything bad. They help Sydney a lot in the comics.
They do. I mean, like, Tina is, I'm not going to say Tina's not hot, but I don't know, she's... As far as, like, she's more the sort of person I'd want to hang out with and, like, date. But she is, like, super cool. Like, I love that she is, like, tries to be, like, a edgy punk, but she's actually a super big softie, which is pretty cool. You know, I don't know. Maybe Tina is an S tier, because she's just awesome. Tina is so great. She's such a lovely person. I don't know. She's so awesome. This is Tina appreciation hours. Sandy. Now Sandy is an amazing character. I think she did. Everyone likes to talk about Joker. I think No Lunch Break did it better. However, Sandy is not someone I want Sandy to get help. She is relatable. I feel really bad for Sandy, and she's a fantastic character, but holy moly, no, I do not want to date Sandy.
They're not ever really fat in the comic, so.
She's a little thick.
Okay, but, you know, it's more of a, maybe they become fat and not like, they become.
Yeah, okay, she's not like Sydney's size, obviously. Also, she's nuts. She's friggin', she's a very broken person who is also magically superhumanly strong. Terrible combination. Look, Grace is bad, but like at least you know she's not like a friggin' like you're dealing with like Superman here. I guess we should move on to the No Lunch Break characters, I guess.
We don't have Chase here. Or...
Oh, we do. Yeah. Oh, sorry. There's I almost no forgot break. Chase. Chase, my boy. Chase is kind of cool. Like, you know, he's a decent looking guy. He's wealthy. I think we established he was wealthy.
Only real issue is he's a bit of a minor character and maybe a bit boring at least.
And a bit of a simp, yeah. he's cool. Would we put him above zero? maybe he's like a B, you know. Okay, we've got the original Kip, Breakfast with Sister characters, starting with, I guess, Kip. But, like, she's cute. She's a cute little person. She's a sweet lady.
Do they ever actually, you know, try and become fat? Like, isn't that normally just an environmental kind of thing?
Probably, yeah.
Like, yeah, they're decent, but, you know.
I don't know. I'm feeling, like, I don't know. I don't like the Kip characters as much as... I mean, admittedly, to be fair, I don't know. I mean, yeah, I don't know. I'd say B for Kip. Kip, I think. As someone said, they do get better later on. Like to start with, they are a crazy frog ninja. They do get better later on, but I don't know. I'm not the biggest fan of Kat. They're a little cringe.
I mean, they do have more of character development, I guess.
They do have more character development. Yes, it's been a while since I've read The Breakfast with Sister. I'm trying to remember. I don't know. I'm more of a No Lunch Break guy, if you can't tell. I guess Kat is kind of... she's very sun, I guess. She's very sun. However, she does also friggin'... She will also probably tie you to a chair and force you to eat donuts or something, which is... Maybe that's something and you're into.
Are they fat themselves by the
they
end
do,
of
They do become fat later okay. on. Yeah, you know, they're kind of cute. They're kind of cute at the end looking, but... See, what are you feeling, man?
C's probably better than D, I think.
Yeah. Grace. Now, Grace is quite pretty looking.
Yes.
However, she is very sus. This woman is the person who friggin' like. I mean, I guess she like look her relationship with Kip is not that bad, but holy moly, like she is a very sus boss. I'm just saying.
Yeah, they do some unusual things, but they do, you know, they're quite a distinct character. They've got some cool.
Oh yeah, like Grace is a cool character, but I'm just saying, do you want to be married to her?
Yeah, probably not.
She will manipulate you and control your life and like ruin your life.
Maybe I think they might be a
She might be A.
Yeah, I think
Grace is A. Okay, all right.
You can disagree if you want to.
All right, fair enough. We'll put her at. Okay, interesting. We'll put her A then. And we've also got the mother.
Yeah, they're just a nice mother, I guess.
Yeah, she's pretty cute. She's nice. She's also like I don't know exactly how old she is. She's like an old. She's a little bit of an older lady.
They're
which,
the only
you know,
person who is like that in the Kip comics.
That's true. The only MILF. So I, you know, she's probably A. She's like super interesting. Yeah. But if you're looking for something like you know, she's pretty cool. And the dad.
I mean, maybe he's a bit absent, but he's...
He's a little bit absent. He's a little bit absent. He does seem to be a decent dude. He got that nice beard, though. Like, he got a kind of, I don't know. I'd say he's more attractive than Chase, in my opinion.
He just faints on the ground during the weird moment, so I guess...
That's true, yeah. That's true, yeah. He's a solid dude. I'd say...
Yeah, I think B.
I think B, yeah. His only thing is, though... He's a little absent. Like, he's not the best dad, but, you know, he's okay. Oh, and before you forget, Daryl Tai.
Seems like just a bit of a bad guy in general.
He wants to stop the fatties. He's Donald Trump in the Kipverse.
I think he has to be, then.
Yeah, I'm sorry. No, I do not want to date Kip Tay-Tay Donald Trump. I'm not gonna lie. Okay, now we're getting into the newer characters with, who should we start with? Connor?
Yeah,
Cindy?
Start with Connor.
Connor, I mean, he's okay.
He seems incompetent, that's why they had to get the babysitter over.
That is true, yeah, like if he was able to look after his little sister himself, forget, they wouldn't even need a babysitter. He just spends all his time on getting dating advice from people on Discord.
He's just a bit foolish. He's not, like, bad.
Yeah. I mean, he's, like, kind of cute looking, I guess. But how old, even old is he?
18.
18? He's 18, is he?
I think.
Guess that's not that bad to still be living with your parents. He lives in his mother's basement. I guess he's okay. Well, what is his redeeming characteristics?
He's not, like, mean or anything, I guess.
He's not mean. He's a nice-ish guy. He's a nice guy, you know? Give the nice guy a chance.
He doesn't seem malicious at all.
No. Maybe he's a C then. Cindy is S tier, right?
Yeah, I think so.
Cindy is like one of the best Kip girls. Like she's so freaking cute. She's so cute and so cool. And maybe also a demon. Maybe also
yeah,
a succubus.
That's never really explored. I guess it doesn't have to be.
I hope we get more of that in like another video. In another like sequel comic to Full Night Natty, because I wanna know more about that. Okay then. And finally we've got one serving choice. I almost forgot the frick what it was called. Okay. Starting with Sire. Now, Sire isn't like chonky, but like Sire is really nice. Sire is really sweet and like a salt. She's like good at, she's like smart. She's
not
nice.
That smart because they're not at actual universities.
So. Okay, fine. They're not that smart, but they're like diligent. They're really sweet. She's really nice. She's wholesome. She's a wholesome man. She likes Pokemon, Pokechubs, Chubimon.
Yeah.
Like, she's not like, you know, she's not like as hot as Cindy, but like, I don't know. She's really, really sweet. And I think, I think she's...
However, they're reasonably thin. So I think maybe that puts them in A.
Yeah. I mean, you would have, yeah. To be fair, not S because they are not. They lack the required body mass. But who knows? That could change, maybe. Aika!
I really like them as a character, but the fact that they don't like Sire is just a big issue for me.
I know, man. I know. It's so painful. Maybe this would change in the comic books, but it's like, why? They are very cute, though. They are very cute and thick, though. But not as cute as, like, Cindy, though. Maybe. I don't know. They are cute, though. They dress in a friggin' anime cosplay to school, which is kind of based. I don't know. I think they'd... She'd still be an A, maybe? Or should that be?
I think I'd say B.
Oh man, that's gonna ruffle some feathers. Okay, also, quick one out of the way. What's her name? Stacy. No.
Yeah, I can't think of any good. Like, maybe they will.
Okay, I'll look, let's put her in D because I'd rather date Stacy than Donald Trump or Sandy, but what? She's thin, she's mean, she's...
But the comics are not finished, and I think Stacy's character likability is only going to go up, really, so...
I will admit, yes, I think we're going to see more, like... likeability from Stacy, but she's never gonna be top waifu. It's D for now, maybe C if she's really, who knows,
maybe even an S later on.
Damn, I don't see it, but who knows, maybe she will become thick and everyone will think she's awesome or something, I don't know. Now here's the tricky one, Tessa.
Okay, I think the later sequence, like from a fat perspective, they're a pretty epic character.
Hot take, Tessa is really hot. Tessa is also, I like Tessa, it's like, oh, she seems like she's like the super cool streamer, but is actually a friggin' nerd who likes Pokemon. Also, another hot take, pre-streamer Tessa is also really cute. Like, friggin' see, when you see Tessa and like her like, oh no, I'm not cool phase, that was also cool. Tessa is a little bit weird though. I mean, I guess.
And like, they could have avoided some drama in the comics.
But. Yeah, oh yeah, she's a bit of a drama queen, yes. I will admit.
But they do help in some way, maybe for their own benefit, but they do at least sort of help Sire later on.
So. They do, yeah. It sounds super normie, but like I would date Tessa 100%. The people she likes, like, she goes a long way to freaking get Sire's attention, which is a little much. But, you know, that's kind of cool, you know?
Yes, maybe.
She knows what she wants, and she's not afraid to go get it.
maybe
not. I don't know. I'd put, like, I don't feel she is really hot, though. I'd say, like, between... But then Cindy, so we've put Sydney on the A, so yeah. Maybe she'd be A as well. I'm like a Tessa simp. I'm sorry, guys. Like I'm really ashamed of myself, but I'm a Tessa simp. I'm sorry. Okay, and then we've got Sean.
He's a relatable guy.
People hate on Sean. Like people hate on Sean in the comics so much. He tries to do his little presentation thing alone, and just gets insulted by his friend. They come over to Sean's house even though his parents are there. He just gets disrespected all the time, even though he's an epic guy. Are we gonna put Sean in the S?
Yeah, I think he has to go in S.
You cannot, that epic hat cannot go anywhere in Sean. Like if I had to pick to date anyone in the Kipverse, I would get down on one knee for Sean.
Yeah.
And his epic hat. Wow, that is the final Kip tier list. I think this is legit. I think this is pretty legit. I don't know if I agree with Grace and S tier, but okay, fair enough. I'll be a Tessa simp, you can be a Grace simp. Definitely let us know how you would rank the Kip characters in as far as waifu husbando material goes, and tell us why we're wrong in the comments or why we're right about Sean being an S tier husbando. And yeah, hope you enjoyed this segment.